when they came to you to bring it to the screen, were you leery of that at all, or did you jump in?
I was leery at first. Well, I was actually even more than that. I was a little upset because I'd written it as a play, and I was, you know, trying to prove my theatrical credentials. And within, you know, because you know, in London I was known as a screenwriter, and then within 2 days, within two performances, a movie out of it, and I sort of thought, oh, but I've been trying so hard. I want to join these guys for a bit, and but you know, when it was Ron, and I, you know, I'd met with Ron on another project, and so we knew one another a little bit, and you know, I was thrilled, really thrilled. I mean, who wouldn't be?
Exactly, with Ron working with you. So were you able to explore and expand on things that you wanted to in the play in the first place?
Well, not that I wanted, because, you know, things that I would have wanted to explore but couldn't, for, you know, for the fact that they were on a confined stage, and so yes, we did a whole extra layer of research and so forth, and there are a number of scenes. I mean, I would have thought about 15-20% of the movie is probably fresh.
Now, is it true that a lot of these people you didn't actually meet until you started working on the film as a project?
No. Most of them on the East Coast. I could only afford a research trip to the East Coast. I couldn't afford both coasts. And so the, Nixon, you know, one always forgets, Nixon is a California... Nixon, you know, I hadn't been to, you know, Orange County. I hadn't been to Casa Pacifica and the Nixon Museum, or indeed Yorba Linda, where he was born. So once I did all that, I really felt I knew both the character and you know, and the world a lot better.
How do you think they walked away at the end, the relationship? Did they respect each other? Is that what you got out of it?
Yeah, that's what I got out of it, talking not only to, you know, to David Frost, you know, but also to a number of the, you know, I think it was awkward. I think Richard Nixon did, you know, I think for him it took a few years, you know, after the dust had settled, really, you know, to re-engage in any kind of public appearances or whatever. Frost went on, of course, as we know, to have a long and successful career, although this sort of interview he never did again. He tried it with Kissinger and it didn't work at all.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Was Kissinger a better, like...
No,
opponent, or?
Frost misjudged it, I think, in a way, and you know, by his own admission. So I think that after, you know, he never did another piece as big as this. So this is very much a story about the highlight of his career as well.